Begin by finding a position for your body that feels comfortable for you right now. Maybe it's sitting in a chair or on a cushion. Maybe it's lying down. In any case, allow your body to get comfortable. It's okay to be comfortable when you meditate. And as you settle into this posture, allow yourself to enjoy that comfort, to notice it and to savor it. It's simple. And it may be small. But allow yourself to notice it and to be nourished by it. The simple satisfaction of being comfortable in the body. If at any point you find that you're uncomfortable, feel free to adjust your posture and make a change so that you preserve comfort as a quality in your body throughout the practice period. So that you prioritize being comfortable. It's okay to be comfortable. And it's okay to enjoy it. Take a moment to briefly scan your body to notice if there's any muscular tension that's present anywhere in the body, in your face or your jaw, your shoulders, your arms, your hands. If there's any tension in your legs, your feet. If you find that your muscles are tight, that you're tensing your muscles anywhere, see if you can invite those muscles to relax, to loosen, to let go. Relax your body. Those muscles may or may not be willing to relax or able to do so at this time, but you can invite them to relax. to whatever extent they do relax, again, notice that and really enjoy it. Savor the simple pleasure of relaxation in the body. If you'd like, if it feels good for you, invite a gentle, easy smile to your face. Doesn't have to be a huge grin. Just a simple smile. These are three qualities that we want to establish and preserve in the body, to prioritize in our experience throughout the practice period. Being comfortable and relaxed with a gentle, easy smile on our face. On the one hand, we want to enjoy these qualities. To allow ourselves to notice the pleasure and satisfaction that comes with each of them, and to really enjoy them. And on the other hand, if these qualities fade, if we become uncomfortable or tight, if the smile vanishes from our face, we can just gently notice that and reestablish that quality. You can change your position at any time to be more comfortable. You can allow your body to relax at any time to loosen your muscles. And you can smile at any time. Take a moment to just enjoy these qualities in your experience, having established them. without losing these qualities in the body, begin to involve your mind, specifically by attending to aspects of your life that you can connect to a sense of gratitude for. Consider what you're grateful for in your life and use mental talk to tell yourself about it. It should sound something like this in your mind. I feel grateful that I have friends. I feel grateful that I have food to eat. I feel grateful that I have a place to sleep. You can use the same thing over and over again that you're grateful for, or many different things, at whatever rhythm you like, whatever pace feels good for you. In any case, tell yourself in your mind, using mental talk, what you're grateful for. Be sure that you can hear these phrases in your mind, that you're using mental talk to tell yourself what you're grateful for. I feel grateful for this, and I feel grateful for that. Feel free to explore the terrain of gratitude, adjusting to what you feel grateful for. to whatever extent you notice that feeling of gratitude in your emotional body, that you're moved by this exercise. Again, notice that and deeply enjoy it. Allowing yourself to savor the joy of gratitude. Very good. Now, let's turn to cultivating love and kindness. By bringing to mind an easy to love person or animal, whoever that is for you, begin to cultivate love for them. If you'd like, you can use phrases like, I love you, or I care about you, or I want you to be so happy, or may you be happy. You can use the same phrase over and over again, or you can use many different phrases, perhaps that are customized to this person and your relationship with them. Mental talk is a tried and true way to cultivate loving kindness. Alternatively, you can use mental images. Perhaps recalling a happy memory that you shared with your easy to love person or animal. Or simply imagining them being happy and what that might look like. Being as detailed as you like. You get to decide what images you use and how you hold them. Alternatively, if you're able to directly connect to a felt sense of love in the emotional body, you can go straight there and simply feel this love for your easy to love person or animal. Or you can do some combination of these methods, these roads to loving kindness. Feel free to go down a road that's familiar to you or to try something new. There's no wrong way to do it. Simply cultivate love for your easy to love person or animal. Whatever method you're using to cultivate loving kindness, establish yourself in it. Stay with it. If you're using mental talk, be sure that you can hear the phrases. I love you so much. I care about you, and I want you to be happy. I hope you're happy today. I hope you're well. If you're using images, stay with the same image or use many different images, but continue to cultivate your use of the imagination as a road towards loving kindness. If you're using the emotional body, stay with the feeling of love in your body. Continue to notice what it feels like and even allow it to expand, to grow, so that you cultivate more and more love. Whatever method you're using, stay with it. As you do this practice, if you notice love arise in your body, if you can feel the loving kindness, again, notice that and really enjoy it. Soak that love up. Attune to it and savor it. The amount of love that you feel may be small, but the way that we attend to it can change the way that we experience it, so that that love and our enjoyment of it grows. Allow yourself to cultivate this love, this loving kindness, as well as your enjoyment of it. This method of having an easy to love person or animal and cultivating love for them is a road to loving kindness. We carve a pathway in our heart from our relationship with this person to love. Continue to practice this love for your easy to love person or animal. But as you do so, become curious about this relationship. Notice that there are various circumstances about your easy to love person that make them easy to love for you. That there's something situational about who they are and who you are and your relationship that circumstantially makes it easy for you to love them. But that they are also worthy of love simply because they are a living being, irrespective of those circumstances. See if you can notice and attend to both those circumstances that make it easy for you to love this person or animal, and the transcendent love that they are worthy of simply because they are a living being. See if you can find that in your experience as you cultivate love for them. Let your practice of cultivating love for this easy to love person or animal be a kind of inquiry or investigation about what exactly is lovable. Can we notice these circumstances that make it easy for us to love them? And can we notice this transcendent essential quality that is also worthy of love, simply because they are alive, because they are a living being? Can we notice that about our easy to love person or animal? Investigate that. What does it mean to love someone simply because they're alive? Simply because they're a living being? Can we notice that quality and investigate it? through our relationship with our easy to love person or animal. Look closely. We begin to notice that simply because they're alive, this person is worthy of love. They didn't need to do anything or be anyone to be worthy of this love. Simply being alive means that they're deeply worthy of love. Allow your relationship with your easy to love person or animal to be a portal to this kind of love. Unconditional love and friendliness. Loving kindness. And begin to notice that quality about yourself, that you are also a living being, worthy of love. That simply because you're alive, you are worthy of unconditional love. Of course, there may be circumstances about yourself that make it easier or harder to love yourself. But simply because you're alive, because you're a living being, you are worthy of love in the same way that we noticed about our easy to love person or animal. We also deserve this love. See if you can notice that about yourself in just the same way. And as we bring awareness to our intrinsic worthiness of love, begin to cultivate love for yourself. Again, you can use mental talk, phrases like, I love you so much, or I love myself, or I care about you. I'll do whatever I can to protect you. Or, I'm so proud of you. Or something more particular to yourself and your life situation. Or you can use images. Imagining yourself being happy. Seeing in detail what that might look like, using the same image or many different images. Perhaps seeing yourself smiling or laughing or flourishing in your life in some way. Or perhaps by directly connecting to a felt sense of love in the body, just feeling love for yourself. All of this with the awareness that simply because we're alive, we're worthy of love. We may have various strengths that we're proud of, that we approve of, that we like about ourselves, that circumstantially make it easier to love ourselves. That's fine to be aware of that, to love ourselves for those reasons also. And of course, there may be things we don't like about ourselves that make it challenging to feel love for ourselves. But we're aware that simply because we're alive, we're worthy of love. And we make that the basis of our love. This simple, unconditional love. That accepts all circumstances. If at any time you find this practice exceedingly difficult, you can switch to cultivating love for your easy-to-love person or animal, or directing love to someone else entirely. You can switch back and forth as many times as you need to in order to connect to this sense that living beings are intrinsically, unconditionally worthy of love, and that this applies to you also. You are worthy of love, and you are worthy of your own love. Feel free to make adjustments as needed. Who you're directing this love towards or how you do it. The most important thing is to cultivate love and to connect to this sense that beings are worthy of love simply because they're alive. And if you can, if it doesn't feel too difficult or overwhelming, direct that love towards yourself, knowing that you are worthy of love. You're worthy of love. And as you're ready, at your own pace, you can come out of the meditation.